Ghost bed or purple? Which mattress is right for you? Hey guys, it's Martin here from Mattress Clarity, and today we're talking about these two mattresses. We're gonna take a look at their similarities, their differences, my experience with both, and help you choose one over the other. Let's get started. First off, if you want to see a list of our top picks for mattresses, head over to mattressclarity.com. There you'll find some great reviews on mattresses, bedding, pillows, and some great discounts on mattresses like the Ghost Bed and the Purple. And you'll also find some great coupons in the description below. So let's start off by talking about the similarities between the Ghost Bed and the Purple mattress. So first off, they're both very popular online mattresses. They both have great customer service terms. In terms of construction, they have the same base layer, a very similar base layer. They're close in terms of price. And last but not least, they are both more responsive mattresses. So now let's talk about the differences between these two mattresses. First off, there are going to be some firmness differences. In our experience, the Purple is softer than the Ghost Bed mattress. Now, speaking of the construction, specifically looking at the comfort layers, there are some different materials there. On top of the Ghost Bed mattress, you have synthetic latex over gel memory foam, and over on the Purple mattress, you have a unique hyperelastic gel polymer. Now, because of that, both mattresses have a slightly different feel. They're both more responsive, but with the Ghost Bed mattress, more of an overall balanced foam feel, and with the Purple, a very unique squishy, firm yet pressure relieving feel. And last but not least, the Purple should be more breathable than the Ghost Bed. So now let's take a look at the construction of both these mattresses, starting off on top and then working our way down. First off, speaking of the covers, on top of the Ghost Bed mattress, a thin breathable cover, similar to what you find over on the Purple, they won't affect the overall feel of these mattresses too much. Now moving down to the comfort layers. First off, on the Ghost Bed mattress, on top a layer of synthetic latex, it's also ventilated for airflow, has some good bounce to it, some good resilience. Below that, a layer of gel memory foam. Add some more of that slow-moving feel right to the top of the mattress. Also infused with gel to help with cooling. Moving over to the Purple mattress on top, the hyperelastic gel polymer forms something called the Purple Grid. It's a very unique material. It is squishy, it's firm and pressure-relieving all at the same time, also very breathable as well. Now below that, you're gonna have a foam transition layer. Moving down to the support layers, pretty similar between these two mattresses. On the Ghost Bed mattress, they have base support foam, similar to what you find over in the Purple mattress. So what does all this mean? Well, as you can see, the main difference between these two mattresses construction-wise can be found in their comfort layers. Again, on top of the Ghost Bed, synthetic latex and gel memory foam. Over in the Purple, that unique hyperelastic gel polymer. Gives both mattresses a different feel and overall different experience. Now, speaking of durability, I would give the slight advantage to the Purple mattress. With that hyperelastic gel polymer right on top, might last longer than the Ghost Bed. And last but not least, speaking of breathability and cooling, I would give the advantage to the Purple mattress. With that gel grid right on top, a lot of room for airflow, shouldn't be trapping as much heat as the Ghost Bed. So now let's talk about differences in firmness and feel. In terms of firmness, I thought the Ghost Bed was close to an 8 out of 10, definitely firmer than average, and the Purple was closer to a 6.5 out of 10, about medium in terms of firmness. I will note though that like I am a heavier person, so when I'm lying on the Purple, I'm activating that gel grid. If you're a lighter person, you might not activate it quite so much. It might feel firmer to you than it did to me. But I think in general, most people will agree the Purple is softer than the Ghost Bed mattress. Now, speaking of feel, with the Ghost Bed mattress, more of a kind of balanced foam feel overall. You have latex right on top, some good bounce there as well. Moving over to the Purple, has a very unique feel. It's also responsive like the Ghost Bed, but with that squishy gel layer right on top, it's gel-like, it's firm, it's pressure relieving all at the same time. A very unique feel overall. So now let's talk about how I feel in different sleeping positions on both mattresses. Starting off on the Ghost Bed mattress on my back, a good balance of comfort and support for me. My hips sink in the right amount, great overall support. I do want to again note though that I am a larger person, I'm 250 pounds. If you're lighter than me, you might not be heavy enough to press into this top layer of the Ghost Bed. It might feel too firm for back sleeping. Moving to my side, way too firm for me for side sleeping. Definitely feeling some pressure on my shoulders and my hips. I definitely need something softer overall for this position. However, moving to my stomach, it is firmer than average. You definitely want something firmer if you're a stomach sleeper. The Ghost Bed's definitely working for me in this position. My hips aren't bowing in. I'm not getting out of alignment. Moving over to the Purple mattress and starting on my back, an even better balance of comfort and support than I felt on the Ghost Bed. My hips sink in the right amount. Good overall support as well. Similar to what you find with the Ghost Bed though, if you're a lighter person, the purple might feel too firm to you. Moving to my side, I'm feeling great pressure relief on my shoulders and my hips. Again, if you're a lighter person, it might feel too firm to you. Moving to my stomach, not a bad match for me. I'm definitely not feeling quite as much support as I felt over on the Ghost Bed. So here at Mattress Clarity, I like to mix subjective opinion with objective tests. And one of those tests is the pressure map. So I lie down on my backside and stomach. You see anywhere from blue for no pressure, all the way up to red for high pressure. Now let's pull up the side-sleeping results for both these mattresses, the Ghost Bed on the left, the purple on the right. Now pay close attention to my shoulders and my hips. If you sleep with a partner, there's two things you want to think about. It's motion transfer and edge support. Now, motion transfer means if you're lying down on one side of the mattress and your partner moves around on the other side, are you going to feel that motion or not? Now, edge support means if you're sitting or lying down at the edge of a mattress, do you feel secure or more likely to roll off and onto the floor? So first off, speaking of motion transfer, neither handles it too well. They're both bouncier, more responsive mattresses. If you want something to cut down on motion transfer, maybe you find something with memory foam right on top. Now, speaking of edge support, I would actually give the slight advantage to the Ghost Bed mattress. It is firmer than the purple. I feel more secure sitting and lying under the edge of the Ghost Bed. And now the moment you've all been waiting for. Which one of these mattresses should you get? First off, in terms of who should get the Ghost Bed mattress, think a better option for fans of firmer mattresses. Definitely the firmer mattress of the two. If you like something with less give, take a look at the Ghost Bed. Speaking of feel, if you like something with more of a balanced foam feel, the Ghost Bed's definitely a better option for you. Has latex right on top, below that some memory foam, overall a good balanced responsive foam feel. And last but not least, probably the better option between the two for stomach sleepers, it is the firmer, more supportive mattress overall. You should feel better support when you're on your stomach. Now, in terms of who should get the purple mattress, I think it is the better option for hot sleepers. The gel grid on top leaves a lot of room for airflow, should sleep cooler than the Ghost Bed mattress. It's also a good option for, I believe, side sleepers, specifically if you're medium weight or heavyweight. When you're on your side and you collapse that gel grid, feel almost no pressure on your shoulders and your hips. And last but not least, the purple is a good option for combo sleepers. The gel grid is a very unique material, has a great balance of comfort and support, should feel good on your back, side, and your stomach. So the Ghost Bed and Purple are both online mattresses. They're going to come to your house in either a cardboard box or a plastic bag. Let's talk specifically about the Ghost Bed and unboxing that mattress. First off, ask a friend for help bringing it inside. It can be quite heavy, you don't want to hurt or strain yourself. Then bring that box into your bedroom, open up the top of the box, and take out your rolled up mattress. Place this on your frame or foundation, then slowly, carefully cut through the layers of plastic. You don't want to damage your brand new mattress. Then clear away all the plastic and packing materials, give it about 24 hours to completely off gas and expand, and you're good to go. So at this point, you should know which mattress is right for you. But if you're still a bit confused, you want a personal recommendation, just leave a comment below. Well, that's about it. If you started looking for a mattress or bedding, head over to mattressclarity.com. We also do a lot of videos just like this with the like button and subscribe.